Ladies and gentlemen, you know who it is. It's the CEO of Fight Night, Joshua Prince. We about to have a good time out here. Ladies and gentlemen, we about to have a good time out here. But like, quick sec, I need to turn off CEO mode. Because I know y'all wondering, why did I come out with my all-stars tied around my waist? But before I can moderate this contrast, I just need to sign off my chest. I'm getting sick and tired of this pride KJ getting matches with the all-star title. But he's not even the real champion. And no one has took this belt off me, but for some reason, they let him walk around like he's the real all-star champion. But you know what? We can handle that at Mountaintop. We can handle that at Mountaintop. You know, I'm not gonna get too much into it, because we got other matters we need to attend to. Right now, we have a contract signing for the for the FCW World Title between Sonic Man and Zion Prince. It's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be back and forth. Back and forth. But you already know. And I'm biased. I got my brother, my world champion, taking this match home. But, you know, right now, I gotta be a neutral party.
Zion Prince, you must be some kind of dumbass. You sit here and claim that I'm washed. That I'm a washed up old nobody that you can easily beat. Yet I always seem to have you beat. I always seem to have your number, both in and outside this ring. I remember a couple of years ago, you were praying on this company's downfall. When we no longer wanted you here, you were saying that you brought the views here, that this place was gonna be back to the indies. Yet when we brought this place back last year, FCW had the biggest views that it's ever seen in history, all without you. Hey, by the way, Joshua Prince, Slaughter would easily destroy your puny little brand Fight Night at Across the Globe. And I'll beat your ass personally, you stupid bitch. You claim in this match that you're gonna beat my ass. Well, that seems to always be the script in your head whenever you fight. You claim you can beat me up and at Mountaintop, and look what happened. I beat the fuck out of you, 7-5. You said the same thing about Across the Globe, and I beat your ass in 10 minutes. Even when I went on vacation, while you were trying to keep your dying career afloat, I came back to revive it and made you the biggest fool in call, and took your OT3 World Championship in 5 minutes, all in the span of 1 month. You say I'm washed? Last week on Fight Night, your own brother said you were washed, that you are not the show-off that everyone once knew. Your own brother said you are a bum compared to the show-off that we all used to know. You fell off in real time. I own you, you stupid, sorry bitch. You need me more than I ever needed you. That's why you're pushing this match so bad, because you can't hang in the big leagues anymore. You can't hang in the world title picture. That's why you're getting bitched around by people like KJ to CD to Jay. And now you're trying to build your career back up by having your little brother give you a prop championship and then try to fight little old me again. A guy who barely ever fights anymore. I mean, like, regardless, not that that really matters, because I'm going to beat the fuck out of you at Mountaintop. And what I do, you will get down on your knees like the bitch that you are, and you will acknowledge me. Acknowledge me, you stupid bitch. Go leave, go form another faction, you know, one of the 50 factions that you made. Go cry to Zenda and never speak on my name again.
You seem a little angry there, my man. You are old and washed up. Just look at you. Only thing you said that was true was that you beat the rock star. On screen, you have. Off screen, I've beaten this walking dumpster fire a dozen times. But even in a tag match, the rock star hasn't beaten this monkey looking fool when it comes to TV matches. Rockstar is beating everyone in some way, shape, or form on card except this guy. Cause I didn't want to hurt his feelings. And every time I beat a person who runs the league that I'm in, they get mad and kick me, which I don't even care about. And that's the show off that my brother was talking about. He's talking about the one that doesn't care. You see, Zion Prince cares about people's feelings. What my brother wants and what he knows is necessary right now is the show off. The guy who doesn't care about feelings. The guy who does whatever he wants, whenever he wants, however he wants. Since you stabbed the Rockstar in the back, that's possible right now. You stabbed the Rockstar in the back because of a Superstar of the Year. Boy, what a league owner we have. Listen, you won't go down as a GOAT, but I will. I just want that win over somebody I haven't beat yet. I'm putting you on. Nobody knows you, even still. Yeah, you won that OT3 World Heavyweight title in a steel cage match. You did not pin the Rockstar in that World Heavyweight title match. That was your first time touching a World Heavyweight title in OT3. I've touched every World Heavyweight title. Isn't it funny that the only places you can really win gold is in your company, the company that you run? We're not on the same level. We don't know you. We know the company name, FCW, and that's because of me. That's because of the Rockstar. That's because of the show off. And there was no need to prey on FCW's downfall, because when you came back, you were dropping shit that wasn't getting nowhere near the numbers that I brought to this company. You couldn't even offer any competition until you dropped a nostalgia pay-per-view. You used the exact same post I blew the company up in popularity with, but the exact same pay-per-view I blew FCW up in popularity with. It added a couple of extra stars from the exact same place that the Rockstar was at, BGE. And when you went up against us with that clickbait pay-per-view in the ratings war, the Rockstar and BGE smoked your pack with a go-home show. Not even a pay-per-view. So that's killed and over and done with. What else you got to say, clown? Go ahead. I gotta listen to you stumble over your words again.
The show off doesn't care about what people think. I do whatever I want, whenever I want. It's honestly like you talk in slow motion. It's real cute that you're trying to lean towards BGE for views, though. You can claim those views all you want. Just know, they don't need you either. Their pay-per-view last year, Bloodthirsty, hit views that you can only dream of. And I know you have brain rot, since you're out here saying I only win championships in my own company. Listen, I've won championships, world championships here in OT3, and I won a world championship in AEW on my first try. And I've won championships all across the globe, BGE included. Just know this. This is your last chance to beat me one-on-one. I don't need this, you fucking dumbass. You do. I'm already 28-9 since you want to bring up the scoreboard and matches off-screen, you stupid bozo. Matter of fact, I know you want to beat me so bad. And since I know you brought up tag team matches, why don't we do a tag team match right here on Slaughter? You already have Joshua Prince here. I can get my partner out right now. Let's do this. Let's fucking go.
Man, don't nobody give a fuck. Shut up. You want a match with the Rockstar? You could do it on the Rockstar show. I mean, look at how clean I look and look at how dusty you look. You think I'm about to allow you to touch me with that dirty ass shit on? Shut the fuck up. This is an away game anyway. Now, so again, the only thing you said that was true was I need this win. And you're right, I do need this win. But not because of your accolades or something. You're still not on my level. No. Beating you doesn't really do anything for me but allow me to say I've beaten everyone I've been booked against. So I feel I need a little more, you know? I think it's time you finally started showing the Rockstar the respect the Rockstar deserves. So at Mountaintop,
here's what's gonna happen. You win, I'll grab that mic and acknowledge you as the GOAT. The question of which is more important, defense or offense, is settled. But I win, I gain partial ownership of this company, and I become co-owner of FCW. I become everyone's boss. The company that I put on the map. I mean, you shouldn't have a problem with that. FCW is known as the Rockstar's property anyways. I had my lawyers look over the contract, and it's a bunch of BS, but as long as them terms and stipulations are in there, it doesn't matter. I know the trick. The narrative you pushing is the truth I told about you and caught in 4K when you stabbed me in the back. You can't accept that the Rockstar proved himself without you. And you can't accept that without a mini wannabe Rockstar, you haven't proved yourself without me. I brought numbers to every single company I stepped foot in when I chose to. I won the World Heavyweight Championship in every company I stepped foot in. You haven't even stepped out of my shadow. FCW is hot again because of the Rockstar. That's why you went and made a piece of plastic for that broke boy to hold even after CD unified the titles. It's because you couldn't accept that the Rockstar was back on top. Great booking, by the way. You're upset at how it happened. Well, guess what? I don't care. The Rockstar took out CD and reaped the benefits in doing so. This is the undisputed unified World Heavyweight Championship that me and CD fought for. The real world title. So nobody cares about that piece of plastic you made up out of thin air since you wanted to try and bring it up earlier. And since you wanted to bring that up, since you wanted to try and fuck with my story. Just like in OT3 when you screwed me and Lafayette for my OT3 Omega title. Yeah, not this time. You not fucking with my story this time. Musty looking bitch.